What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice. Look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Hello and welcome to the Liberty A-League Women's Highlight Show. I'm Tara Rushton. Let's take a look at all of the round one action. The newly branded Liberty A-League Women's kicked off their 14th season in Australia this weekend, and it was the brand new franchise Wellington Phoenix who got the campaign underway in Wollongong against the Western Sydney Wanderers. The commentators for this game, Teo Palazzieri and Georgia Yeomandale.
See their possession stance there. Wanderers controlling it, but is it meaningful possession? Can they get into dangerous territory as Sheridan Gallagher is challenged? Allen to Gallich. Through the middle, this is Sheridan Gallagher as the shot opens up and she hits the crossbar. Nearly a dream debut for Sheridan Gallagher. Alfeld left stranded, but the woodwork comes to the rescue.
What a strike there from Sheridan Gallagher. Great build-up. It's probably the best build-up we've seen from the Wanderers here. Bianca Gallich with the no-look pass, and Sheridan Gallagher, she can hit a ball. She trained with us last season, and she's the kind of shot that you want to duck out of the way when she's coming through.
Here goes McMeekin again. We know right now she's got the measure of that right flank. Lifts it into the box, and a flashing header. Not trying to score with a high degree of difficulty, but that is another good sign for Wellington.
That's a fantastic ball in there from Zoe McMeekin. She gets really good whip on it, and the Western Sydney Wanderers backline unable to deal with it.
Pritchard. Full speed at Caitlin Cooper, who did not move. Just a good stand-up tackle, taking the ball away. Straight out to Holloway on the right, and now Gallagher. Only Habuda in the box. Numbers come in to join, and it's a good late run from Holloway and an even better stop from Alfeld to deny it. Now that cross is going to drift away, but Lily Alfeld, when called upon, comes up with a good save. Collister's cross deflected. Annabelle Martin is there. Referee looks at the watch. Wellington Phoenix take them seriously. It is the most celebrated nil-all draw in New Zealand football.
A fantastic point for the newest side in the A-League Women's. Two-time champions Canberra United hosted Melbourne City at Viking Park as both teams expect to lift silverware this season. It was a welcome return to professional football for Rebecca Stott after 348 days out of the game due to Hodgkin's lymphoma. Your commentators are Ben Homer and Grace Gill.
Dangerous delivery. Heyman in there. Sykes, what a chance on return for Ashley Sykes. Heyman spotting space for the former City player, Rabin. Keir, first time delivery. Heyman on the stretch. That's better from Canberra. And Middleton stabs it forward. Heyman in behind. Hudson smothered it. She wasn't to know that the flag was up. That's a fantastic save from Mel Hudson, coming up off her line. No chances at all for Canberra in the second half. They are stuck in the mud, stopped. Great ball, Wilkinson. And Wilkinson on the second attempt, it just beat her over the byline. They were that close to the first goal of the Liberty A-League, Melbourne City.
Oh, well, Rebecca Stott, what a lovely little reverse pass there through to Hannah Wilkinson, and she'll want to have done better with that. Lauren Keir followed her runner the whole way through, so credit to her for putting the applied pressure, but what an opportunity for Melbourne City.
Now flicked on to Wilkinson, another chance, great save, Keely Richards. A couple of chances in the last minute for the Kiwi, Wilkinson. She'll be keen to get herself ready for that round two clash as the ball looped in and picked up by McNamara. McNamara! On debut with a stunner, Holly McNamara. Remember that name. She puts Melbourne City in front on the road. And it's the first goal of the Liberty A-League.
Well, Melbourne City have certainly had the run of play for these last few minutes, and McNamara able to just take a nice little touch back in, a drop of the shoulder to open up some space for herself, and Keely Richards, not too much she could have done about that one. McNamara just with enough room to get a really sweetly hit shot away, and what a debut for the youngster.
It doesn't get much better than that for Holly McNamara. She's had chances so far tonight, and the teammates rush over and congratulate her. Well, Grace Marr, how big is that chance? Going to come back and bite Canberra. Wilkinson now. Wilkinson touched over by Richards. She has had a great night in goal. So after a disappointing last season, Melbourne City are back in the winner's circle.
Sydney FC got the action underway on Saturday afternoon. The visitors to their adopted home in Kogra were the Newcastle Jets. Teo Palazzeri and Georgia Yeomandale are your commentators.
Hawksby back to Ray. Fenton tried to jump the pass. Courtney Vine turning into a bit of space and fires a shot into the side netting. Courtney Vine threatening early, and Claire Coelho able to watch that flash past the post. Is going to turn and play it back to Ali Green. Green against Franco. Tries to back her speed here, and she wins the battle of strength. Ali Green in behind the defence. Coelho with a parry. Vine unmarked in the box. Can she get the volley right? Not quite. Simpson saved by Coelho. And what a start to the season from Claire Coelho, making a point blank save from Remy Simpson. They are a very young team, Sydney FC, and I guess it's because it's a number of players that we're used to. We forget that they're still only in their early 20s. They really don't have that many adult leaders out there.
Yeah, look, it is one of the younger side.
Here's Simpson against Brewer. She's found her way through. Remy Simpson gets her goal, and persistence pays for Sydney FC as they take a 1-0 lead.
Was probably the more difficult of the chances for Sydney FC, but Remy Simpson's done well to get in behind and put that one in the back of the net. That'll give them a lot of relief coming into this second half.
Green trying to lift the free kick to the edge of the box. Fenton. And now Hunter. It's Sarah Hunter! And straight into the clutches of Coelho, not able to shape the shot enough to cause any further problems.
Great feat there from Sarah Hunter on the edge of the box, being able to skip through a few players.
Oh, not good passing out of defence. Courtney Vine trying to return it with interest here. It's Vine, it's a beanie! And it's two for Sydney FC! And the front trio are on song now. Princess Avini joins the scoring, and Sydney lead 2-0.
Unfortunate for Newcastle Jets to cough it up in their back third, but what a great ball across from Courtney Vine.
Javer following up, Harding's flick header on. Not done with yet, Lauren Allen steaming through! The Jets have got a goal, and it's the subs harding into the path of Lauren Allen, and it's 2-1 now. Newcastle are back on track.
That's the quality that Lauren Allen possesses. She's got the pace to get in behind, and she's done so there.
Here's the corner from Hawksby, in at the near post, and turned in. Courtney Vine got the last touch. And Sydney's forward trio have all found the back of the net on the opening day. Let's see if they've still got enough pluck about them to get back in the game again. Dolvik putting it into the path of Harding. She's never scored a goal in the National League, Harding, and she's trying to turn provider here. It sits up. Here's the chance for Brodigan, and she's denied. by the woodwork. So close. Just harassed by Sunny Franco. And then she kept her feet, Rule, and so came away with the ball. Out to Princess Abini. Can she run this down? You can see it's caught the wind. Abini, does the roundhouse around the corner flag. And Tiana Jaber might be off here if she gets booked. Big decision for the referee. It's game over for Tiana Jaber as she receives her second yellow card. But it will be a winning start for Sydney FC that boots on opening day of the A-League women's season.
A fantastic win for the Sky Blues on their opening match of the season. Join us after the break as we conclude the opening round of the Liberty A-League Women's. Welcome back to the Liberty A-League Women's Highlight Show. Next up is Perth Glory, who failed to win a single game last season. They take on Brisbane Roar at Stirling Park. Your commentators, Adam Papalia and Jamie Harnwell.
Tano, and a real scramble in the box. Another golden opportunity there for the Roar, but not able to capitalise.
Well, that was a much better chance than the last one. Hecker. Ball got all the way through, deflected. Got a good touch out of her feet, perhaps not quite far enough able to wrap the foot around the ball.
Connors with a good turn.
And the deflection away, but it's gone in the back of the net. And the Roar open things up here in the West. A great start for Brisbane. The Glory defence under all sorts of pressure. It took a touch on the way in. And it is 1-0 in the West. Margraf right in amongst all the action as we check the Harvey Norman replay.
Well, it comes from the throw. It's too easy. Anton gets turned way too easily. Ball gets played across. It's Sarah Carroll with the last touch. Connors will try to claim it as it comes across. Or is it?
Margraf may have got the last touch on there. I thought it looked like an own goal to start with, but I think Margraf was waiting just in behind. Over the top to find Devanna. Now Perth on the attack. Lisa Devanna! So close, still alive for the Glory. He's touched by the keeper. It touched the crossbar as well as it came down.
Chance before Devanna. Straight off the crossbar. Was there even a touch? Not sure there was.
Ishinori chips it up. Crummer's got the height there, flicks it on. Back post, Margraf had a real lash at it. Off the bar or the post and ricochets away. Already scored her first goal tonight in the A-League Women's. Very nearly had her second.
Well, was left alone at the far post. Was it Hannah Lowry? Ball watching. Gee, she hit that well.
Right for Rigby. Crane wins it here. A good challenge. Still got the speed to go past. On the shot, they scramble it on the goal line. And they scramble it in. Perth Glory have equalised late on in this match. Incredible stuff with some late drama. Susan Fonsonkan able to make the impact in her debut for the Glory.
Well, it's all about Gemma Crane, isn't it? She's been the one most likely all night. She won the ball back, fires it across. Probably Hooks couldn't get there. Fonsonkan could. But Gemma Crane, that's just determination to get the ball back. Drops the shoulder, whips the ball across the face. Fonsonkan sticks out a leg. Alex Apakis loves it. It means a lot to him. It means a lot to this side. And they're back to 1-1. And can they now go on to get a late winner?
Crane still fighting for it. Trying to go past them all. Rash out. Oh, mistake in the back. And Worth has seen it roll past her. The Glory take the lead. A disastrous mistake by the keeper, and in the blink of an eye, the Glory snatched the lead. A tough one to take as we check the Harvey Norman replay.
Well, it's just a long ball from Kim Carroll. Gemma Crane doesn't give it up, but Worth will not want to see that one again. You've got to pay credit to Crane. It's played back. It's a simple one to control. Lets it scoot past her foot with the touch.
It has been the most bizarre couple of minutes of football. And we see the final whistle. And in quite unbelievable circumstances, the Perth Glory break through in the first game of the season to take their first win after a winless campaign last year.
What a finish to that game in WA. The final match of the round, reigning champions Melbourne Victory took on South Australian side Adelaide United. Calling all the action, Simon Hill and Amy Chapman.
Father Tom played in the NSL and of course, oh, here's a mistake by the goalkeeper. An absolute gift wrap goal. And Leah Privatelli could not miss. Oh dear, Adelie Grove. A horror show, completely missed her kick.
Local MPLW competition. Here's an opportunity. Good try. And Casey Dumont was happy to see that one flash wide of that left hand upright. It was Emily Condon with the left footed effort and it very nearly curled in. Curled it around the last defender. It's Withers. Oh, now Catherine Zimmerman was clipped there, yeah. Isabella Blass points to the penalty spot. Morrison against Grove. Grove saves it, but the follow-up is tucked away by the American. And Victory do now have that two-goal cushion. It's just Kayla Morrison's second goal in the A-League Women's competition.
Which Kyra Cooney-Cross will deliver towards the near post. It's gone all the way through, and it's three. And it's Claudia Bunge at the back post. Jeff Hopkins' team having a dream first half. And it's the central defender at the back stick who applied the finishing touch.
Here come Victory again. Withers waiting in the middle. Oh, it's caught off the frame of the goal. Harriet Withers with the touch that took it away from the goalkeeper and was only denied by the upright.
Yeah, as we get another look at this Harvey Norman replay here, it's a great ball in and, geez, Withers has done well to get in front of the goalkeeper there and I'm not even sure how physics, she must have been the outside of the boot there to get that on the near post and, geez, that would have been great for Withers' confidence to score this early on.
Sprayed nicely by Nevin. Barbieri. Trying to pick a way through, but Shea Evans said, not on my watch. Condon. And just slightly too well. I was going to say too far in front of Paige Haywood, but she's too strong for Polly Dorrit. Here's Wirtz again. Here's looked the most likely for the Reds. And hits the crossbar, Fiona Wirtz. Out for Evans. She couldn't control her shot. And Victory a little bit fortunate there. They're still not away. Will be now through Cooney Cross. Maybe Jeff Hopkins is right to scribble some notes in that black notepad as Cooney Cross continues this strong run from midfield. Zimmerman, it's there, it's four from one end to the other. Adelaide hit the crossbar at one end, but Kyra Cooney Cross is the architect at the other. And Catherine Zimmerman has her first goal of the season. And Victory have blown out to a four-goal lead.
You can see the tempo just slowing here a little, Simon. The players getting a little bit tired and looking forward to the halftime break. You can see the sun is out and be very, very warm. But certainly a lot to work with going into halftime.
It's going to be four additional minutes, we're told, because of that injury. And that's a really good try from Fiona Wirtz, who's looked by far the most dangerous for Adelaide, the striker that joined the club from England.
That's a really decent strike here. She's got it on her left foot, as we see on the Harvey Norman replay, and she's almost curled that one in. It's 4-0 to Victory here, Simon, but Adelaide have not been without their chances. Geez, that's beautifully struck.
slung forward by Stanbury. Got the best clearance from Polly Doran, and charging forward is Emily Hodgson. They've got a chance here. Emily Condon, and couldn't quite angle it into that bottom corner. But that was a good side of goal that for the Reds.
You can see she's finding herself in great space here, and probably be wanting to have done a little bit better on that one. Didn't get quite the whip on it she needed, but the fact she can turn on the top of the 18-yard box, great signs for Adelaide. A little bit concerning for victory there in these early minutes.
Perhaps again a little sign of that defensive readjustment that they've been forced to undertake, victory. Morrison and Nevin started the game, now neither on the pitch. There's the free kick for the Reds, and it'll loop up, and Casey Dumont had to palm it behind. Was on target, might have crept in at that near post.
A decent delivery in there, and again, you'd want victory. Casey Dumont's done well in a difficult position there. Clearly, Beth Hopkins drilled it into them. A near post run is essential, and they've almost come away with a goal a couple of times on that occasion.
Here's Condon, slips it through, chance, Chelsea Dorber. It'll break, surely a goal now, yes. Fiona Wirtz has the goal that her performance undoubtedly deserves. She hit the frame of the goal in the first half, but Adelaide are on the board, their first goal of the campaign. And Fiona Wirtz, the English girl, has it. That's the midway point of the second half. Oh, and it bounces up on the crossbar, and in it goes off Leah Privatelli, who has her second of the game. She opened the scoring on 11 minutes, and she was stationed in the right position as that ball bounced back off the crossbar, and victory and a fifth goal.
Privatelli, she will be thanking her lucky stars. It's a second goal for her today, but it's all in the delivery for me. The corners today have been excellent. And
into the box it goes. It's a good first touch by Haywood. Goodness me, that was close. I think she's picked up a touch of cramp as well. Paige Haywood, she's worked hard this afternoon. Worked well in tandem with Fiona Wirtz. Will be able to run it upfield through Paige Zoyce. I look for the switch, it's a pretty good one too to find Withers. Flowing football by the victory, it's Harriet Withers! She probably deserves a goal today as well.
What a contribution from young Paige Zoyce coming on there. She's got composure and a great switch ball, as we see Harriet Withers with the little 1-2 here, and has deserved to get on the score sheet today.
There's going to be no time, though, for the corner to be taken. Harriet Withers will have to wait until next week. Kyra Cooney Cross provided a couple of assists, smiles and a handshake between the two coaches. But really, this game was done and dusted by half-time.
Melbourne Victory pick up where they left off last season and are definitely one team to catch. That's it from round one of the Liberty A-League Women's. Join us next week for more action.